That's the God that I'm serving. And can happen to anyone, my friend. Can happen to you, wherever you are watching, wherever you're listening from. See, the more you draw closer to God, see, the elements of God, the unseen elements of God will be drawn to you. That's why the people, they ran away from Moses. Why? He was speaking to God in Mount Sinai. So when he came down, he looked different. Hallelujah. The same Moses that he went up, the same Moses came down. But what's the difference? His eyes changed, his hair changed, his voice changed, because he was in the presence of God. Hallelujah. So, my brothers and my sisters, those of you that are watching this program, hallelujah. When you improve your prayer life, I tell you, you become a man of authority. Hallelujah. Man of authority. Whatever you say, the demon will flee. Hallelujah. The demon will flee. I remember when Jesus came back from the mountain. Hallelujah. The disciples were trying to cast out demons from a boy. So the father of this boy came to Jesus and said, I took my son to your disciple. They tried to cast out the evil spirit, but they can't. And Jesus said, I command you, get out. Just one sentence. Get out. Evil spirit, get out now. I say to you, get out. Hallelujah. And that boy healed instantly. So the father of the boy asked Jesus, why when I took my son to your disciple, they can't do anything. Evil spirit still there. Hallelujah. And when they left, Jesus spoke to the disciple and he said, this kind evil spirit. He said, this kind, the evil spirit, the spirit that brings sickness, the spirit that brings fighting, adultery, stealing, lying. Jesus said to the disciple, this kind, you can only cast them out through prayer and fasting. Hallelujah. Whew. Bible says, hallelujah. When Jesus spoke, things happened. Why? Because most of the time he spent nighttime on top of the mountain or in a solitary place. Hallelujah. In Luke chapter 4, 31, 32, the Bible says, then he went down to Capernaum, a town in Galilee. And on the Sabbath, he taught the people. They were amazed at his teaching because of his word had authority. His word had authority. Hallelujah. Oh, it's really a challenge. For me as a pastor, hallelujah. Me as a taltala, me as a preacher of the word. His word is with authority. Hallelujah. So whatever we preach, people, they either like you or they hate you. Why? Because your words had authority. That's why it's very important to pray and pray and pray. If you are listening to me and you continue to go to church without prayer, I'm sorry to say that you are wasting your time. Hallelujah. Go to church, good. But you should do what is taught in church. And the things that you are taught in the church, you don't do it in church. You do it with your life. Hallelujah. Get away from sin. Kaka, don't touch it. You pray. You fast. You read the Bible. Hallelujah. We go to church. It's like a training ground. We go to church to get trained. But you must do your own training. Hallelujah. I remember when I was back in the 90s, I used to play for St. Mary and for Nandi. St. Mary is the club and Nandi is the district. Hallelujah. The training, the team run is not enough for me. I have to do my own running in the morning. During lunchtime, I have to run through the cane field in Botolibu areas and do my weights. Hallelujah. I'm not relying on the team run in the afternoon because I need authority. I need power. I need confidence with my body. I need to build up the strength within me. So I have to do my own. So if you are going to church, you need to do what is taught in church. Hallelujah. Now there is no church. Your church now is coming through the Facebook. Hallelujah. And we are blessed of this technology. Imagine if there was no Facebook. Hallelujah. Where we will get all this thing? I want to challenge our life. The Bible says, then he went down to Capernaum, a town in Galilee, and on the Sabbath,